Yes, as we said, we have these two alternative ways of making this investment. The first case is let's do our timeline again. So we have this. Now let's use the T1 for the first maturity, and for the second maturity we use T2. So as we said, we can invest either from time 0 to T1 and then reinvest from T1 to T2 using the forward trades. The second alternative is to directly invest from the beginning until T2 using the zero rates for the maturity T2. And in this example, we said if you invest directly for 2 years, that's what you get. And alternatively, if you invest for 1 year, this is what you get. But notice that we can generalize this using the continuous compounding here. And the key here is at time zero, these two alternative investment choices must have the same value by the no arbitrage condition. If there is any deviation, that means one of the interest rates are not correct. So this should be basically exploited by the investors, and the arbitrage opportunity should disappear in an efficient market. So here what we can notice is that the direct investment for time T2, this is what you will get at the end of T2. And here what you see, the first part of the investment from 0 to T1 is e to the power R1 T1. And then you are reinvesting this quantity, and you are multiplying with e to the power this RF, which is the forward rate, from T1 to T2. So since these are multiplied, you can just sum in the exponential, and you equate this equation. So what is unknown in this equation is the forward rate. So we can solve this equation with respect to the forward rate, and by taking the natural log of both sides, you can simplify and get this one. So in this equation, now you can solve for the forward rate, and you can obtain this expression by reorganizing this a little bit. You can represent the forward rate in terms of the interest rate for maturity T2 here, which is R2. And this is the difference in the interest rates and the difference in the maturities from T1 to T2. So another interesting thing we can do is we can look what happens instantaneously to the forward rate. So in other words, we can find what's the instantaneous forward rate for a very infinite small time maturity from T1 to T2. So if we take the limit for T2 approaching to T1, what we get here is actually dr dt, and we can obtain the so-called instantaneous forward rate in this expression.